In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate a 3D logo while keeping all of its colors. And we're going to begin this tutorial in Adobe Illustrator. Once you open it up, click on New File, then make sure you switch to Pixels. And here I'm going to create a square 1080 by 1080 document. Click Create. Then add your logo by just dragging it in. And the Burger King logo works really great in this example since it has many different elements and different colors. Now, once I add it over here, you can see it's a very high resolution, so we need to scale it down. But first, we need to zoom out. We do that by holding the Alt key and then scrolling the mouse wheel. Then in the Tools, make sure you're selecting the Selection tool. Then drag on any of the edges by holding the Alt and the Shift keys together to scale the logo up or down proportionally. Something like this works fine. Then in the Properties, you'll find Align tab and just align the logo horizontally and vertically to put it to the exact center of the frame. Then go up to Window and make sure the Image Trace is enabled. It's this tiny window over here. Now, based on the colors of your logo, you're going to use either one of these presets. A quick note, if your logo is completely white, make sure you change its color to black or something else before adding it to the Illustrator, and then proceed with the rest of the steps. Again, based on the colors of your logo, you're going to choose either the high color or low color preset. And in my example, there are not that many colors, so I'm going to use the low color preset. Just click on it, and then if this window shows up, just click OK, and then give it a few seconds to process the image. And after the processing is done, if you get color bandings in your logo, that means you need to use the high color preset instead, and then proceed with the rest of the steps. So after the processing, we're going to click Expand, and then we need to click and move everything off the frame, either to the right or the left, does not matter. And to pan the view, we're going to click the mouse wheel and move the mouse. Now in the Tools, we're going to select the direct selection tool, then we're going to click away to make sure we're not selecting anything. Now we need to select the background by clicking on it and move it slightly to make sure that you're moving the background, then press delete to delete it. Now if you have a closer look at your logo, you'll notice that some of the letters and the shapes have their insides filled with white, and we need to clean those up to make them transparent once again. And we do that by clicking on the area and pressing delete, and this tiny piece as well, just select it and press delete. And after you've cleaned up the logo, we're going to drag and select everything and then move it back to the center of the frame. And after that, we're done in the Illustrator, so let's go up to File, select Save. Now give this a name and select the output folder, then click Save, and also click OK in this window. Now let's close Illustrator and go to After Effects. And once you open After Effects, we need to create a new composition by clicking here. I'm going for 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. Then switch to the 3D Renderer tab and make sure you set Renderer to Advanced 3D, then click OK. Now let's add the Illustrator file with the logo that we've just saved to the project. And once we import it to After Effects, it's going to ask us how we want to import it. And make sure you set Import Kind to Footage, and this one should be set to Merge Layers, then click OK. Now let's drag the Illustrator file to the timeline. Then we're going to right-click on it, go to Create Shapes from Vector Layer. And at this point, we no longer need the Illustrator file. You can either delete it or keep it hidden. I'm going to select it and delete it. Now we have the shape layer that contains the logo inside of it with all of its colors. And we're going to make it 3D by checking this icon. If you don't see this option, click Toggle, switches on Mode, and then enable 3D by checking this icon. Now let's expand the properties of the shape layer, go into Geometry Options, and here we have the Extrusion Depth. I'm going to set it to 200. Then for the Bevel, I'm going to select Convex and set Bevel Depth to 4 to have nice bevel on the edge of the logo. Now we're going to go up to Layer, New, Null Object. We're going to make the null object 3D by checking this icon. Then we're going to set a view to two views. Make sure you have the second view set to top view. Now while the null is selected, we're going to move it on the z-axis until it's in the middle of the logo, and that should be 100 pixels since we've extruded the logo by 200 pixels. And the reason we do this is because this will make the logo rotate evenly on the y-axis. Now after you move the null object, let's switch back to one view and then parent the shape layer to the null object. And here we have the parent and link column. Just drag the pick whip from the shape layer, drop it onto the null one, and let go. Now we've parented the shape layer to null 1. Now if we select the null 1, press R on the keyboard, that'll bring up the rotation values. And let's move the time indicator to the start of the timeline and create a keyframe for Y rotation by clicking on a stopwatch icon. Then let's go 2 seconds forward and set the rotation value to 1, that will be 360 degrees. Then let's drag and select these two keyframes, then right click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or you can press F9 as the shortcut to smoothen out the animation. And now if we do the quick preview, here we have a rotating logo. Now let's add a light and give the logo shadows. For this we go up to Layer, New, Light. And for this, we're going to select the environment light, make sure cast shadows is on, click OK. Now, if nothing happens, you want to make sure you go into the material options for your shape layer, and here, make sure accept shadows is on. Then let's go back to the light settings, expand those, light options, and the shadows could be a bit grainy when the shadow darkness is set to 100%, so I suggest you drop it down to something like 75%, and that'll soften out the shadows. So here's a quick before and after. And here's our final result. Now, if you don't like this animation, you can add a camera instead and animate it to your liking. And that's it for this one. Thank you guys for watching.